invisible force. Astounded, he snatched his hand away, but he wasn't fast enough. The glowing blob somehow stretched, darted forwards like a snake, touched his fingertips, sucked at them. "Help me!" he shouted, trying to shake the nugget free. But it was clinging on, beginning to distort and flow over his fingers like thick glue. "It's eating my arm!" Panicking, he brushed at it with his other hand, and the glowing, flickering metal began to devour that too. "No! I'll get help," Adiel told him, slipping back through the narrow gap in the boulders. He tried to follow her, but got wedged in the opening. "Adiel, come back!" He turned sideways, tried to squeeze through, but now his red-gold arms were rising from his sides of their own accord, anchoring him against the rock. Through the gap he could see Adiel fleeing away from him, down the sinuous passage. Only his screams followed her. Doctor Who, The Art of Destruction, by Steve Cole, read by Don Warrington. Engines rasping like a giant's dying breaths, the TARDIS forced itself into existence in the middle of the crop field. Finally, there it stood, improbable and serene under the baking sun, an old-fashioned police box like a big blue blot on reality. Its owner sprang from the box with the grace of a gangly gazelle, eyes wide and dark, brown hair bouncing over his brow. He puffed out his cheeks. "Flaming hot, isn't it? Sawn in the Sahara sort of hot." Rose Tyler smoothed down her light blue T-shirt so that it covered the waistline of her short denim skirt. "Where are we this time?" "Not sure," the doctor admitted. "Lots of weird alien static about when we dropped out of space-time. Clogged the sensors." "So this is a planet that sees a lot of space traffic, then?" She stepped out and looked round at the rows of towering crops. "Seems quiet enough. These plants are weird, though. Kind of like fat corn." "Sort of," the doctor agreed.